Welcome everybody, this is Mr. Fugu and you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we will be creating a nested dictionary using JSON formatting for a fake data set. As always, the code will be linked in the description below. The objective today will be to create a nested JSON object, understand the pitfalls when you're using data frames to create these, evaluate data frames that are dumped as CSV files in either JSON or dictionary formatting. Then we will create a function to properly store our data and then describe the format and ability to send it to Mongo if needed. That's optional. So we're going to use Faker Pandas Random Request Beautiful Soup Regular Expressions. Okay, this data set is basically, assume that you were in the position of being a recruiter and you were looking at people by first and last name who had particular skills. They had a state that they lived in, a specialty, and their willingness to relocate or not. So here's our skills list that I created. We have this function where we're creating random skills, where we're generating a seed, giving us data consistency. We're going to have 500 people. I put this here because we're generating random ints where you're going to have at least one, all the way up to the length of the list. I did this because I wanted to have a person that has at least one skill all the way up to all of the skills in that list. And then we append that into our list, and that looks like this. So you say the first person in the list has six skills, next has six skills, next one has one skill, etc. Then you iterate through that list, and then you have to use the extend so it's not nested, and you say, okay, this randomly sample all of the skills, and this enter the number of skills that each person is going to have. So then you create that list and you return it. And here it is. You have six, one, and then eight. So that works out perfect. Next thing we want to do is create another random seed so we can create our names. So we're having 500 names. We're saying, okay, if we're trying to create non-duplicate names, but you can't have real duplicate names in the real world, but in this case I didn't. So we're going to split those on a space, because in the original string here is creating a string with the first and last name split on a space, but I wanted to split it on a space so then we have each one of them separated. I got a list of the US states, abbreviation CO, CA, FL, you know, etc. So I went on this web page, used some web scraping to practice my skills so I don't forget. Found that it was in this particular div column. Everything was stored in a table formatting. This is the attribute where the class color BG green stored all of our information. Then we went into the TR tags, made sure to use UTF formatting, split everything on a new line. Okay, cool. Then we take our tags and say, okay, let's only look for the tags with the strings having a capital A through Z and only taking if they have two back-to-back letters. So then that delineates your, you know, your state abbreviations. Then I just parsed through and replaced anything that had a TD tag and just replaced those with basically empty space. And then here we go. Here's our random list of states for our 500 people. Then I did a random.choose, so like n choose k situation. And you do 500 of these that you want with our state abbreviations. So, oops. Okay, so let's find out. Oh, that's why. And here we go. Here's our people and their random states. Now, are these people willing to relocate? Yes, no, or maybe. Then we created 500 of those again with the random.choices. Now we take our specialty here and our experience level. We do the same thing. And I said, okay, let's try to create a list of tuples where we're saying, all right, each tuple, I'll show you real quick, has our specialty by name and then what their specialty is. So here it is, specialty machine learning, specialty data visualization. All right, cool. Then we're creating a dictionary formatting here for each of those. And it looks like this, specialty data bases, same thing you'll have for the experience levels. Then you could say, all right, let's look at them together. If you zip those together, and here's what it looks like. So tuple of dictionaries. Okay. Now I'm taking the first name and the last name, zipping those together with all of our data that we generated. And this is what the first two entries look like. First name, last name, skill set, where they're from, and then experience with their specialty, and are they willing to relocate. Then create a data frame with all of the column names and dump this as a file and show you the head of this. Here is our tuple dictionaries here. And then here's the rest of our data, and it looks pretty good, right? But then let's look at what this file looks like, and here's where we start encountering some of our issues. Okay, so okay, let's just dump this file. So maybe I store it somewhere else. Job seekers, it's not text. It's CSV. Oh, because I got this in a different... Okay. There it is. All right. Here's our header right here. And since we have a nested dictionary, it's storing these as entry 0. And then it has all of your information with it separated by your new line. Here's the next one separated by a new line. Fine. But look at that. So now you have your list getting stored as a string. While normally this is an issue, you could store this just like this and then import it back into a data frame. And that's just how the formatting natively works. But if you would like to preserve your data and not have this happen, and not have this happen again here for the other one, for this one as well, you have to either store it as a pickle, but then I'm not sure how you're going to import it into other things. Here, I was using this data set for a importing, exporting through MongoDB, and this formatting doesn't work for me when I'm calling nested methods. So how do I rectify this, right? I create a function that actually does this for me. Okay, so I'm calling this, we're going to start with candidates. We're taking the list with everything that we have, all of our columns, and we are creating an unnested candidates data frame. Okay, so now I don't have any of that nesting gobbledygook, right? So here we go. So we create that, and that'll let us start with what we need to do. So nested JSON function, where we're taking a data frame, we're taking our candidates, and then I just abbreviated this, chopped it up, but we're throwing in states, right? So you take your JSON variable, where we're taking a dictionary where we have features and an empty list where we're storing everything, and we're iterating through our dictionary. And for our variable feature, we say inside of features, we have candidates, which are dictionaries. we iterate through each of our candidates, and we store our key value pairs, and then we append our dictionary features with our list of features that we just created. Okay? So, after you do that, you need to take your column names from your data frame. You need to put that here, and then what you're calling in, which is my unnested candidates data frame. And then now it prints out like this, which is the formatting I was looking for, where I have candidates, where this is the first, let's do this, so you can see where it looks like from the beginning. So you gotta start with features, that's what I'm calling here, and then everything else is nested list. So then we take our list of nested dictionaries, and we have candidates, and inside of candidates you have first name, last name, skill set, state, specialty, experience, relocation. You don't have that string junk in front of this anymore, so you're good to go, right? If you wanted to take this, then you can send it into MongoDB. You can send it into other databases. You could manipulate or play with it, do whatever you want. But today you learned how to create a function that creates nested dictionaries. You can also take this out and I changed this up. I'd have to add it in here. But then you can use something like this and then nest it even further. But nevertheless, I was going to show that. But that's the end of this video. As always, please like and subscribe. And turn on that notification bell so you can see the next videos coming out. Thank you for watching. Have a good one. Bye.